Hey there YouTube. Okay, so in front of me there, this here, this is a linear power supply. It's one of the Banggood power supplies, 0 to 30 volts. I think it's like 2 milliamps to 3 amps. Now I did a video on not the build as such. That's a lie. I did the video on the build of the board, and that was quite a while ago, and then I put it in this enclosure sort of and kept taking the transformer in and out. And then yesterday I did a video showing what I'd done inside, and it's in two halves, and the second half the camera went a bit yampy on me again. I thought I'd actually figured out this camera, but I haven't. And I was doing like a load tests just to see, you know, what it was like, trying to drag a couple of amps out of it, and for ripple using my oscilloscope, and it's pretty damn good. I'm quite surprised actually, but I can't show you that because that wasn't in there. But just at the end of this little segment part, I'll show you the insides of it. I know it's all set up there now, but I've already done the video of the insides, and I'll just attach that onto this. But before I actually lose that, or because my channel was more about my log, you know, and what I'm doing. It's not really a tutorial channel or anything like that. I've not actually got around to inventing anything yet, or it would be great if I could, but it's more of a log. It's my progression log on, you know, this hobby, electronics, and part of that is, you know, building into these enclosures and doing bits and pieces, and every time when I do it I learn a bit more and try and improve. And although I've not made great stride forwards, I'm improving. There are, you know, I'm getting better, because if you look back a year of me doing this and you see the first little power supply I built, you know, I've advanced quite well, and that's what I joined YouTube for, was to basically see if I could use the internet and the resources of YouTube and the like to learn electronics and to get into this hobby and make it into a lifetime hobby for me. You know, something I'm gonna have an interest in for the rest of my life. So, you know, so far so good. I should make a video maybe about the road so far, because it's got its ups and downs. It's not all just clean plain sailing, and it's such a massive subject as well. If you think about it, I mean, if you think about just from a component, about the component, how it's made, and then you've got all the physics-y type side, the equations, the maths and everything else. Wow. And then you've got the equipment. Oh. And that's even before you learn how to read a schematic or put a circuit together and test it. There's just so much to it. So I digress a little bit. But so yeah, at the end of this, this little tiny segment here, I'll just show you what I've done on the insides. Now, it's not like the professionals do. I've seen a couple of other guys on here, and you know, they do it very smart and etc. I'm not like that. Like I said, I'm just a year in, and maybe in 10 years time, you know, I'll be at that stage maybe, and mine will be great like theirs. But so I just want to, at the moment I've not actually got a plug on this. It comes down into this, which is working out really, really handy, because I can connect my little adjustable transformer, AC transformer up there, which I've now got my voltmeter on, and that, and this is all bolted together now. So when I pull this out, the whole unit comes forward. It's all bolted in. There's some lovely bolts there. But it comes into this, and I don't actually think that's plugged in, so I'm gonna just plug it into. Well, I've just plugged that in. So little neon lights on, and I've got a fuse in there. It's rated too high really for this little circuit. But it's, you know, it's okay. So if I just plunk that down. These things are absolutely brilliant. I'd say to anybody, you know, you want to get yourself one of these, because it does have made life very easy up here, being able to just connect stuff in that doesn't have a plug on it. So if I switch this on, now this will measure up to 10 amps. Now, in the video when I'm showing on the inside, it'll explain that the transformer I have got in here is too big, really. This is a 3 amp board. The transformer is capable of putting out more power than that, so if I were to put a big load on it, the transformer would try and dish out the power, but the board will die in between. And I do explain in that video that I don't really mind that so much, because even though I'll be very careful about what I put on here, and I am going to put some resettable fuses in to govern that output of power if I can, and I'm also going to look for a transformer which will just do the job, you know, be the 3 amp. But to be fair, this one cost me £19 that's in here, but I think it's like 5.5-6 amps, and the 3 amp ones are nearly £30. So I've got the little LED there that was on the board, so I've got my current control, which is really good. And of course we've got the full power, it'll go up to 31.6 I think at its volts. Turn that up. We've got a 10 turn part. Now I should probably, it's not a straight, on the 10 turn born, it's supposed to be 10 turn part that I've got, it's not a straight, you can't just change it over those 10k pots. The wiring's slightly different. I think I've sort of explained that inside the, if I turn the amperage up there a little bit. You'll probably want to settle out and warm a little bit in there. So there is a little bit of a fluctuation there. But I'm sure that will settle out anyway. Of course, like I say, it's all current limited, so I can back that current down and forth. Down we go. Basically, I'm just, you know, like I say, it's just my log, and I'm just... I'm going to have that as my linear supply, and that means I've got two that work on the mains and two that work off the batteries, because this one works off the batteries, the solar batteries, and this one works off the solar batteries. Of course I've got the boost converter in here first to take up the power, and then this drops it down. It gives me a lot of control, which is great. If I, that's probably going to be on if I switch this on, so I got the one down there as well, which is great for the lower voltage stuff, because that's not directly from the batteries. And this one's great for when I do the high voltage stuff, because I can flip this on and we've got this nice bit of power supply there. And of course I don't, this will take maximum of 60 volts in, and this of course will give me like 85.5 volts basically out. When I've got a little bit more power on the battery, it'll give me that. But if I were to use this now with that like that, it would pop it, and that wouldn't be very good at all. So, yeah, turn it off like that. So I'm quite chuffed with this. I'll do a video on how it copes with the power. I did do one, like I said, but I've lost it, because this little camera that I've got starts going a bit yampy, and then it doesn't save the actual file. So you basically just lose what you've got, but I have got part of it, and I'm going to join that now to the end of this. So cheers for watching, and have a little look on the inside of this. Okay, so I've been playing with this little like linear power supply circuit. These are the ones that you can get from Banggood. I think they're about £8 at the minute. I got this one, it was less than £7, so, but I've had it for a little while, and I've been putting this thing in, taking it out, putting it in, taking it out. But I've decided that I'm probably going to sort of have this as a little linear now. It's not, as you can see, you know, the best of setups, but then I don't profess to be the best of setting upper, best setting upper, etc. I don't know, some proper words in English. I wound some extra wire, magnet wire around, because this was ideal for powering this display. But I couldn't find, I made a little board up, 5 volt regulated board. But I just thought to myself, well, what I can do is I can just take it off this 24 volt coming out of here. Put a resistor on it, and that'll be okay. You know, for the board, it's got a 220 ohm resistor. I'll do the math and I'll put it on the screen. You know, when I've made the video, just to let you know what's going through to here. But it's not, you know, it works. It's okay. And I've got a couple of fans here. I can't remember where I got this out of. Some power supply from a server or something. I can't remember. But I've just used the same gunk as what you use for putting capacitors in. So that's what's holding this all down to the side, to the bottom of the case, and it works quite well actually. I could pick it up and shake it around. It doesn't come out. These elastic bands aren't really needed now because these are actually gunked to the edge of here. But I'm just going to leave them on there anyway, because once I put the top on, no one's going to notice and it's going to be facing away. But I've put a 220 ohm resistor there as well, a 5 watt one, because I noticed with the 2 watt one it was getting quite warm, but the 5 watt one hardly gets warm at all. But it just means that these two, they're in series, and putting off that 24, and they don't particularly blow too fast or loud, but fast enough to make this a different temperature, you know, cooler. So that's good. And the only differences I've done with this really is, you know, I've got a 10k pot here for the volume, for the voltage, I mean. I've not wired in the switch just yet, it's just coming directly out the back of here into here, and this transformer it's got more capability than 3 amps, and they sort of say that you should only put a 3 amp, I think, well, I think it's 3 amp max transformer, but I think that thing can dish out about 5 amps or something. I'll think about what I'm going to do with that. Probably do it through fuses. And I've got a switch in the front of this anyway. I put that in before. I put a little hole in. It's not quite full. It's just, I used a rounded head type thing at the back so the LED fits in there. It's a different LED. It's still a red one because I'd actually put it on the board, and rather than, I did try just to unsolder it from the board, but it was a bit of a pain in the backside, so I just ended up just snipping it out. And then just putting this wire. Hey, you can see that, okay. Putting this wire on. And that just goes down there, look, as you can see. Sorry about the light, it's a bit terrible, isn't it? So, anyway, and I've made the adjustment. I used the old to calibrate in. So, on here, we got 0 volts when it's at 0. I'll show you that now. So, you can. You can see those fans spinning around, but you can hardly hear it, can't I? It's all those plenty of wind coming out of there. You can hardly hear it. Oh, I've lost my stick. So down here we got our internal up nicely. And if we want to, oh yeah, these knobs. Now I bought these. I bought these quite cheap. Well, I bought them very cheap for two of them. I think it was like £2.35. Including the shipping, and they came with these knobs, but one just falls off, this one. That's no good, and this one I can't actually get it to go on. Oh, and this one's just fell to pieces. Oh, I wonder what that's all to do with then, this screw. Maybe it's got something to do with that screw in there. I don't like them anyway, they're a bit annoying. They sort of like just feel a bit weird, and I prefer to turn this, but I might just find another knob for them. But I've got knobs I can put on here, but look, we got the little red light will come on. If I put the meter on here, it says, oh, I suppose that's because, let me just put that on there just to make sure we got some pressure there, and if I turn that up a little bit, so we've got, what, 2.84 there, 2.87 there, they're not, you know, greatly accurate, and these two are going to be different to each other. But if I turn that down all the way to zero, We should have zero over there. It should go down to zero because I've already calibrated this in. Because I have to give it just a little bit of time for it just to, yeah, just warm up a little tiny bit. But that should go down to zero. He says. Might have to just give it a little bit of adjustment, but I'll just, oh, there we go, zero. Just drop me stick. I don't know why that says 1 milliamp there when that's supposed to be all the way down. And then when I do turn it all the way down, it says like minus, you know, 0.53. But we'll just give it a little tiny, just that little red light stop it from. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's supposed to work like this. Now, what I've got to do is, I'm going to put my scope on in a minute. I'm going to let it warm up first. I won't be filming when I do that, but I'll let it warm up and then we'll do a little bit of a ripple check, because it's only got like, there's a couple of little tiny capacitors down there, little 47 mics. And there's a few tantalum. I can never say that word, I don't know why. They like blemange. But nothing's getting like particularly warm. I suppose that like 24 volt is slightly warm, but it's got a bit of a heat sink on there, so just keep an eye on that. Be alright. Doesn't get any warmer what this 5 watt resistor does there. But we've got to stick a load on it anyway, and see how it goes from there. And I will get the switch wired up. I just got to consider the fuse. I've got to get my fuse and stuff sorted out for there. But that's going to be the interesting part. What will it do under load? What will it look like on the scope, you know, when we put when it's drawing, let's say, 2.5 amps or something, and just see what it looks like. Because I've seen linear regulators and they need some capacitance on the input, you know, to stop the input ripple. And I've got some. Look at that baby. That's 10 millifarad. I've got a bunch of them up there. Came through today, very nice. But they're not going to fit in there that well, I mean. The wires parallel underneath there or something. I'm not sure. I don't even know if they're going to be needed, to be fair. We'll just have to see what happens, because, you know, I'm pretty new to all this stuff anyway. And I took out the other. I had some different ones of these in. These, but the problem with these is that there isn't, you can't like unscrew them and then just wrap a wire around. Where on here, you can unscrew these nice and wrap a wire around. They've actually got holes, and I might have to, well, I will make an adjustment. I'll have to just slide this out and adjust it so the holes are going through the top. You know, so if I've got a piece of wire, I want to put it through the hole, I can actually see how the minute's at the side. Which could be okay at the side, I suppose. I don't know. This one's at the top. So it'd be nice if they're both, you know, the same. But I can still wrap the wire around there, it'd be quite nice, and you can still use the banana fittings. And I'm not sure if it's the standard correct size, because I don't actually have anything, you know, manufactured that is got the standard correct size there to compare it to. But I haven't got any of those types of adapters anyway, so I don't think it really matters. Well, not for me, it doesn't matter. You know, some people might say, oh, well, that's a load of rubbish because I haven't done it to the right sizes. But then there's a whole load of things I haven't done to the right things in here, so, you know, people can pick fault with it. It's easy to pick fault with it. I'm a complete and utter amateur. Sorry, my phone was flashing at me. I had to just answer it. Where do we get to? £45, which is basically what this has cost me to put together. I could have bought a cheap switch mount. But this is a linear, and the nice thing about this is, you know, I've got a bit more experience on making up the box, the enclosure. But the nice thing about it is, if it does go pop, it's an £8 replacement. This gets quite warm. I'm a little bit worried about these wires here, but I've decided that I'm gonna put a load on it a bit and just leave it going for an hour or so and just see if there's anything detrimental happens to these wires. If there is, what I intend on doing is, because these are just like hookup wires and pressed onto these connections, I can just undo them, put some heat shrink around that. I probably won't heat it, and I'll just put them back, but have it as another barrier between this and the wires. So that's it. That's the little power spot. I'm going to power it up. Now, my connection here isn't so great, because in hindsight, if I were to redo this now, which is another advantage of building your own, I would move this down slightly and probably try and put in one of them proper connectors. But then in some ways, part of me argues, well, why should I? Because then I'll have a big wire sticking out the back. But I suppose it would be better for transporting. But I've still got those options. I don't intend on moving anywhere just yet. And I would probably have rebuilt this. I'll probably do it next year. Give myself a year. Now, the way I look at it is, this time last year, the little power supply I built on a breadboard was basically a little voltage regulated power supply with a little tiny transformer just to play around with. And now, a year later, you know, I've done this as well as others. And in a year's time, I'm going to do more. I'll do it better. Maybe I'll treat myself to another case and set the same sort of thing out again, but in a more professional manner, as I get more experience. And that's the way I intend on doing these things. So I'll just give you a little quick demonstration of just putting it on, and you know, I know you probably pretty much know what to expect to see. But by using this through here, of course I've got a switch, and then there's a fuse built into here anyway. It's too higher rated for this, but. And even though I've already got a connector block here, if you see, I've put some of that elastic in the top, so it does make sure that the mains there is isolated through there. So that is a little bit of a safety thing going on. And this is all elasticated in. I don't know if that's a word, elasticated. It's that white stuff that you put around capacitors anyway, and I put a whole load of hot snot or hot glue around that as well, just to keep it there. But it's probably gonna sit on top of there. As you can see, I've moved all the stuff off there and I've placed it there once to see what it'd be like, and it seems like it might be okay. Then quite a handy place to get it, and it just means that if I can't use the batteries over there and the batteries on this one, because that's linear and that's switch mode, I can use the switch mode powered from the ATX. You can see that switch mode powered from the ATX, and then I got this linear one that will be powered from the mains as well. So either way, I'll have power. Batteries or not, I'll still have some power, and two of them, because you always find that two power supplies, at least two outputs, can come in handy. Okay, right, so we got that on, so I'll just switch that on. There's no real noise from the fan. It's set at 9.29 volts. 9.3 really is what I was looking for it, because I've got to build up a little kit and that wants 9.3 volts to power it. This is pretty quiet, but there's a nice little airflow there, and this does get pretty cold. It's a lot colder than, you know, everywhere else. Then again, this one feels pretty cold too, and I'll stick a load on it if you just bear with me.